Very pleasant morning, dear students. Welcome to English class. Now we are going through the poem, The Tale of Custard the Dragon, poem number 10. The first 9 stanzas we have discussed, and we came to know that Belinda was the mistress and she is consisting some 4 different kinds of pets. All her pets were Kitten Ink, Mouse Blink, Dog Mustard and Custard the Dragon. Among those 4 different kinds of pets, dragon was looking so magnificent. It was large, huge, but it was such a coward. So when the pirate entered the house of Belinda, Belinda's reaction and other animals or all other pets at the home of Belinda, they all ran away. Until then, they all have shown off their way of behavior, their attitude of bravery. But when the right time has come, when the pirate entered the house of Belinda, all of them have taken flight. Okay, now let's go on to stanza number 10 and 11 and 12. I'm gonna read it. Pay attention and try to understand and appreciate the poem. As we came to know that Ogden Nash was a witty poet and he has written mostly the mockery, that means the making fun of the things and making fun of the situations and the people around. He is known for his literary nonsense. Okay, Ogden Nash is known well for his literary nonsense. Let's move on to page number 130, 10th stanza. It goes like this. But up jumped the custard, snorting like an engine, clashed his tail like irons in a dungeon, with a clatter and clank and a jangling scrim, and he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. The pirate gapped at Belinda's dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. He fired 2 bullets, but they did not hit him, and custard gobbled him every bit. Belinda embraced him, mustard licked him. No one mourned for his pirate victim. Ink Blink in glee did gyrate around the dragon that ate the pirate. So what did the custard do the moment it had seen the pirate entering and causing, and it is about to cause a great harm to this rest of the pets as well as Belinda the mistress? But up jumped the custard. What did the custard do? It jumped up, snorting like an engine. What does it mean by the word snorting? Please underline the word snorting. Snorting means it's like an explosive sound that comes out when we are forcing of breathing the air. Whenever we are breathing through air, okay, one's nose will be making a kind of sound. It's like an explosive sound. Whenever the explosion, okay, wherever the explodes or exploding, okay, by the time it gives out a kind of sound. Okay, when the custard was breathing out the fire through its nose, it was forcing the air which he was breathing. Please underline the word snorting like an engine. Okay, snorting like an engine. What is this literary device we can see here? It's a simile. The way the sound that is produced and the water vapor comes out of the engine, in the same way, when this custard, the dragon, was snorting, the same kind of smoke or a kind of explosive sound that was being generated out through its nose. Okay, clashed his tail like irons. Okay, the rattling kind of tail was there. The custard is having a long tail. It is consisting certain segments on it, and it was clashed his tail like irons in a dungeon. Please underline the word dungeon. Here, dungeon in the sense underground cell. Dungeon is the underground cell. Clashed his tail like ants in a dungeon. It's an underground cell with a clatter and clank. Both words clatter and clank and jangling, all of them are related to, they're all referred to, all three words are referred to the sound that's made by some metallic things which are striking on the ground or striking against any hard thing. Okay, clanking, clattering and jangling. What it was jangling and clattering and clanking, you know? The scrim. What does it mean by scrim? Scrim in the sense, it's a wriggling motion. Okay, the dragon was moving with the help of its segments on its body and the hard outer cover of its body. I think you might have seen the picture and the poem which I have been sent it to you in the previous class. Okay, it was clattering and clanking and jangling with a great scrim. Scrim is nothing but the wriggling motion of this dragon. He went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. How a robin, the blue colored bird, will catch its prey, the worm, in the same way it tried to catch hold of pirate. He wants to gobble him with the help of his claws, that the hand is consisting, the four hands are consisting the claws in it. He wants to catch hold of him and gobbling him. Gobbling means gulping at once. Okay. He went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. How a robin goes near the worm in order to catch its prey. In the same way, this dragon was moving towards this pirate. The pirate gapped at Belinda's dragon. Okay, what did he do? He gapped at Belinda's dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. In his pocket, there was a flagon. Flagon in the sense, it is a large container of liquid, or it's a large container of liquor. Okay, he had a liquor tin or a container in his pocket. He took it out from his pocket and he just gulped it. Okay, and this is called a grog. Grog is nothing but the most powerful liquidized liquor part. It's a liquor. Okay, grog is given, the meaning of the grog is given on page number 132. Grog is a drink typically drunk by sailors. Especially who drinks this liquor? Sailors only drink this liquor. Especially this man is a pirate. A pirate is a sea robber. Maybe this White House of Belinda is located on a ship. Okay, it is not there on the land. But all the land pets were there in her house. In her White House, she kept all four different kinds of pets of different kind of behavior. Okay, the pirate gagged at Belinda's dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. He fired two bullets. As soon as he had seen the dragon, he had taken his flagon and he had drunk that grog and he gulped it. After having that drink, what did he do? He fired two bullets. But they did not hit the dragon, because nobody can kill the dragon so easily. Dragon is such a powerful animal and it was such a powerful a living thing or living creature on earth. Okay, he tried to send the two bullets into its mouth and custard gobbled him every bit. What did the custard do? It has gobbled. Gobbled means take it as a whole and gulping into the body cavity. Okay, it had taken. Okay, it gulped those two bullets as soon as this pirate sent them off. Belinda embraced him. Belinda was really surprised. Until then, Belinda thought that the dragon was not that very brave like other pets with her. But now, at this moment, this dragon, the custard, the dragon, shone its courage and valor. Belinda embraced him. What did she do? She embraced him. Mustard licked him. Licking and embracing or hugging, what of these? Showing affection and love towards someone or something. Here, both Mustard. Who is Mustard? The yellow dog started licking its body. And Belinda, the mistress, started hugging him. No one mourned for his pirate victim. Nobody felt sad about pirate, because pirate is the one who causes great damage and he hurts the people. So no one mourned for his pirate victim. Ink blink in glee. G-L-E-E. Glee means pleasureful. So they were so excited, because until then they had not seen the Custer as brave as the Belinda. Okay, when we read about Belinda, Belinda is as brave as the barrel full of bags. Okay, she was being compared to the barrel full of bags, isn't it? And Ink Blink were so happy, they were got excited to see the Custer, the dragon, who was showing his adventurous deeds and did gyrate, means they move around in circle. Okay, moving around circle is nothing but celebrating that moment. They started celebrating the moment of praising the Custer around the dragon that ate the pirate. What did the dragon do finally? It has eaten the pirate who was started fighting with the dragon. And dragon and other pets of Belinda were so happy. We still have got 3 more stanza. In the next class, we will discuss. Until we meet again, good boy. And you have to take a very good care about yourself. And every day you need to spend good time on reading. So I request every one of you to read this poem, and you can really enjoy it. There are too many literary devices expressed in this poem. I request every one of you to go through carefully. Bye, take care.